years are some of those incredible numbers we've just kind of been agape at.
Yeah, we certainly have it. You know, we're talking about also not only lake effect snow. If you live on the south inside of Lake Conway, Lake Livingston, or Lake Houston, the air is going to be so cold with that strong north wind that we could actually see the snow develop over the lakes and then push into certain areas to the south. And that means some of those areas could take up a couple of extra inches of snow. Check out these temperatures. 29 right now, Bush, 25 in Conroe. It is now 18 degrees in College Station, 23 there in Katy. Moving ahead towards 7 o'clock in the morning, we are already down from 11 to as much as 16 degrees at Bush Intercontinental Airport. Temperatures do not recover for tomorrow. And tomorrow could easily be the coldest afternoon ever observed here in Southeast Texas. It gets a lot worse. We head into 6:30 in the morning on Tuesday. We're flirting with sub-zero numbers up here in our northern counties. 5 at Bush Airport. That would tie the all-time record low. 10 in Pearland. And folks, I think the number I'm most impressed with is 18 degrees there on Galveston Island. It takes quite a hat trick to get Galveston Island into the teens, and it certainly looks like they will be there. Again, temperatures do not recover heading into Tuesday afternoon, which enters in the mid-20s for daytime highs. That means all the ice and snow we get is going to stay there. Couple that with a strong north wind, that heavy snow pushing through, we are talking about whiteout conditions and wind chill values as low as 15 degrees below zero. Data for the first time in our history, we have a wind chill warning in effect, something the National Weather Service has never issued here in the last 150 years since the National Weather Service has even been in office.
So we've already had a first with at least the issue of the potential for wind chills into that warning criteria.
We'll have to wait and
see if that does play out, but it looks likely. And again, Blake, that 5 degrees, that would tie the all-time record high set back in 1930. I'm still amazed that you and I are alive to see this, because this is a once-in-a-lifetime event.
Yeah, it looks like a lot of college students, even 100 years from now, will be doing thesis papers on this event.
They may very well. Okay, let me show you the timing on this. So here's our parent storm out near Del Rio. It's just about to hit Austin with heavy snow. It moves into Houston as we head toward midnight tonight. That's heavy sleet, heavy snow. There it comes in. That's midnight. So it snows from midnight through 5 a.m. That's 5 hours of moderate to heavy snow. That's why we're expecting several inches. It exits by 9, 10 o'clock and moves the snow into Alexandria and Monroe, Louisiana. How much snow computers continue to put out? 4.5 for Bush Intercontinental, 5 inches for Hobby, 6 inches for Brenham, 1 inch in Galveston, Pearland almost 5 inches. And you know, I'm a little concerned these numbers are low, Lenina, because of the lightning that's showing up. That means we're convecting, that means we're going to wring all the moisture in the vertical column out. These snow totals, man, are being low by the time it's all said and done, guys.
We're at 5, our lowest recorded, January 23rd, 1940. Boy, I should like to hear you too. Don't make remember this one. 9 days in a row, below 32. 12 degrees on January 11th, 1982. And then Bush, December 1988, 6 days in a row, below 32, 7 degrees on December 23rd, 1989. So there's a look at the future cast. And as we tighten this up, you can see when ice goes to snow, this is 3 in the morning, continues right through 6 o'clock. And look at that. That's some snow on Galveston Island. We got some light snow now. You may have never been into this before it's all said and done. I know the cloud lake already has problems, so be careful down there. There's the clouds as we go into tomorrow afternoon. So this high continues this cold flow. That low comes in and gives us even more problems. Justin's been putting together a whole map on where we have some of the lowest traffic issues right now. Justin?
Yeah, it's really interesting. Here's how I take this poll. I'll show you. If you normally would look at this map and the traffic map, you say, oh, that looks like it's the middle of the afternoon. It's, 10:20 at night, and all of those spots that say ice out there, that's where we're seeing those closures. That over Jonathan saw the crashes, but of course, what we've been seeing with the bridges and overpasses that are shut as well, and as Frank mentioned, we are not going to see temperatures above freezing for at least 24 hours. Expect a lot of those to continue, Frank.
I think it's us to the north, but it looks like as we go into Thursday, a little bit of the last minute snow and ice wants to continue to come on down. So the full forecast, I have to show you, looks like this. 30s and 40s and 60s and 70s, 16, 10, 30, 24, 22, 34 on Saturday. We don't warm up until Sunday and Monday of next week. We'll be right back. Stay with us.
Hear from you.
comments on our, you know, like these here, saying, you know, it's been out more than 3 hours in Bridgestone.
Morning. Everything is off, including, of course, the sliding doors to get into the lobby here. We've been hanging out here, as I've mentioned, for the past 4 hours or so.
Of course, I'll have the latest on those numbers straight ahead.
To the extent you see yourself getting very low in terms of your battery power, or you don't have enough oxygen, please contact 311, 311, 211, if you'll reach out to us. In some cases, you know, we'll even be trying to reach out to you, but these are the critical care customers who require medical devices or oxygen, things of that nature. If you see that what you have is running. Relatives, neighbors, friends, to check on our seniors. Many of them rely pretty much exclusively, for example, on television. And without power, they may not be getting these reports. So please pick up the phone and give them a call and check on our seniors. But the roads, bear in mind, the roads are hazardous. Let me say, with regards to the airports of this
and our county partners, along with our private sector partners, Mayor, this is a team effort. Everybody's coming together, working together to keep the city safe and make sure that we have an adequate response. The Georgia Brown Convention Center, as the mayor said, is almost at capacity. We are looking at other shelters. We do have the ability, some of the shelters have lost power. We're moving folks from one place to another, but we're all doing the best we can and working as hard as we can. Thank you.